Kia ora, good evening. An investigation is underway into whether Air New Zealand's been breaking the law by helping the Saudi Arabian military. The company has suspended work on the contract for the Saudi Navy, and airline boss Greg Foran has spent the day apologising. Political reporter Benedict Collins broke the story last night and has today's developments.
The condemnation has been swift.
Regardless, it just doesn't pass New Zealand's sniff test. Obviously, this is something that has ramifications for New Zealand, its reputation.
I'm alarmed by it. I think most New Zealanders would find it unacceptable to be doing that work.
Within hours of last night's One News story, Greg Foran was on the phone to the government.
As a chief executive, he has apologised because he agrees that is not acceptable.
Right, when did he apologise?
Last night.
And the apologies kept coming.
I'm sorry that obviously it's occurred, and that for our customers and also our staff.
So how did Air New Zealand's gas turbines business end up working for the Saudi military, who are fueling a humanitarian crisis in Yemen?
This is a case of bad judgment. We've made some poor judgment. We've made bad judgment. We could have made better judgment on this. And, you know, I welcome the fact that there's now some scrutiny.
Is it legal what you're doing?
That's something we're working through with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade at the moment. So we've been in dialogue with them over the last 10 days.
So you're not sure at this stage whether doing this work is legal?
No, that's something, as I said, that we're working through with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade at the moment.
Does Air New Zealand have blood on its hands?
Air New Zealand, as I mentioned right at the beginning, is actually, you know, working through this in a very, very sensible way.
Officials are now investigating whether the airline breached our export control rules. The third-party contract for the Saudi Navy work was actually signed in 2019, before Mr. Foran was in charge. If it happened during Christopher Luxon's time as boss, he said he didn't know about it.
I have no recollection of it. It might have post-dated my time. It's good to see that they've, you know, come out and admitted this morning that, yes, there's an error of judgment, and, you know, they're wanting to do something about that, which is, and stop that, which is great.
Some say the incident should be a wake-up call for the government.
I would absolutely like to see the government develop a national plan to ensure that human rights are respected in our business dealings.
Despite Air New Zealand's apology, there could be serious consequences on the way.
And Benedict is with us now live from Parliament. Air New Zealand's made another decision about the work it's doing for the Saudi Navy, we understand, Benedict.
That's right. Good evening. Yeah, at lunchtime today, in that interview that I had with Greg Foran, he told me, look, they were carrying out a review because while they had finished work on two engines for the Saudi Navy, they had a third engine sitting in an Auckland warehouse, basically sitting in pieces, and they weren't sure whether or not they were going to complete that work or not. They have now made that decision. They've terminated the contract, and they've said they're going to send that engine back to the Saudis in pieces.
And of course, we heard from Greg Foran earlier. How did a major company like Air New Zealand not know whether it was legal?
Yeah, I mean, this is fascinating. So if a company is going to export goods that are sensitive, say, for example, to be used by a foreign military, then they have to go to the government and get a special permit. Now, these permits will not be issued if those goods that are being exported are going to undermine peace and security, could possibly be used in crimes against humanity or in war crimes. Now, you'd think exporting engines to the Saudi Navy might tick all of those boxes. Now, officials in Air New Zealand, they're now sitting down figuring out whether Air New Zealand did need to have those permits because they didn't have them. Now, Air New Zealand could face some serious financial penalties if it is found they didn't need these permits.
Ngā mihi, Benedict. Political reporter Benedict Collins.